when we look at generations,
yeah.
If do you know any generational programming? If yes, what is it? If no, it's okay.
Actually, not all. I know, but just a little bit. Okay, because I'm not really interested with the history. Okay, so actually we start with the low level. Okay, so means before this we okay the generation actually more on low level, more on the machine language that we are not understand. Is it? We can stop.
1:37 later.
Okay, so the previous one I say about the machine language, that one 0101. After that, actually assembly language. That one also, only the machine that can understand. After that, we move to the high level programming. That one we understood.
Last question, madam. Okay. So can you tell us about the problems faced by students when they are doing programming?
The problem actually comes from the in terms of the critical thinking, okay, itself. Okay, because when student have the problem, somehow like student don't know, okay, how to solve that problem. Somehow like you get the problem, then you don't have any idea. Okay, so if you look at the problem, so somehow like you must get the idea, okay, this one, what is it? I need to do, what is it? And then we need to process, what is it? And then you must get the idea like that one. The logical thinking for that. So, I think only that one can differentiate between you and the between you and your friends. Okay, because of the syntax itself, that one is standard, is it? So when you understand the concept, that one is not very difficult. The difficult actually how to get the logic, okay, to solve that problem. Okay, so I think in terms of programming, somehow like mathematics, okay, that you need to do the exercise, okay. But if you not do the exercise, somehow like because that one is come from experience, because you get this one, you get okay, you will know how to solve this one, like this one.